go to the video.
I have to run over there, yeah.
It's never ending. But right now, we got a match going, I think. I think I see Jackal down there. Jackal and Rags.
Okay, so this is, I'm assuming, Rags, that was the MK player from before, and Rags was OD back in Smash 4, right? Then, I mean, if this is, you know, what you were saying, winner semis, it says it right there in the top left. You bet that it is. Person moving into winner side top 64 tomorrow. So this is where all the money is on the table. Now, we've seen Jackal already today, but we have not seen Rags. Of course, you know, it says at Rags MK on Twitter, but clearly that's not who he's playing, right? Young Inkling God.
We saw a lot of Inkling towards the beginning of this game's lifespan, but we kind of started to fall off because people started to realize Inkling has kind of trouble killing. Inkling has really good stuff. Like, that roller is still really, really good, but Inkling does have a little trouble killing, so it's going to be interesting to see what Rags does, because I've seen a lot of Inkling players that kind of start getting desperate for the kill a little bit. Once it gets a certain high percentage, they'll start just throwing out smash attacks left and right, because they do have good smash attacks. Like, I will say that up smash is a really, really good up smash. However, it's a matter of you got to be smart with what you throw out here and not get punished so much for it. But right now, Wolf, as we discussed before, one of the better characters in this game, one of the more pocket characters in this game that everyone really has a good feel for. Wow, that was a trade, and that was a death, actually.
Wow, I didn't actually think he was going to be able to recover there, because I definitely saw him burn that double jump before he opted to go for that. But somehow, Jude, you know, of course, Jackal was able to come out on top there. Rags now fit for that KO, coming to some rollers come out, maybe try to get the ledge get up option. But man, is Jackal just doing an amazing job extending this lead. There we go, grab, then go for the fourth throw, tech setup. Oh, went for the dash attack to cover it immediately. Now Smash might have come out too slow, but tried to go for the two frame.
Tried to go for it again, but actually recovering a little high above ledge right there. 166, this is what I'm talking about. This is where Inkling struggles to kill, and look at that. Wolf just like, you can't kill me, I kill you.
I mean, yeah, it was easily executed.
Gonna go for that side B. No.
Oh. Okay, yeah, I'm trying to, I don't know, just, yeah, I don't know, man. He just messed up. That's really all it is. He just messed up, but hey, what
it's one
better
stock
position to be in? You know what I mean? Yeah,
yeah.
You got a two stock, sitting pretty. He's still working his way in, and it seems like a lot of the times, it's Rags getting stuck, right? Like, he's trying to short hop and do an aerial, and already Jackal is there doing an aerial of his own, like a nair or a falling forward air to stuff out whatever aerial he's trying to do. So now it's up to Rags to maneuver his way around, but he won't have that chance in this first game, baby. Jackal taking that in a convincing fashion, 2-0.
This one I'm talking about.
I mean, well, not 2-0, just two stock. Yeah.
I got you. But, like, this is what kind of what I was talking about towards the beginning. Like, Inkling has that trouble killing. You saw Jackal at 166% easily for most characters. That's around that kill range. Inkling kind of have a little trouble. The only reason Jackal even died was because of a misinput, it looked like. Right here, like, it was good use of the bomb right there, but, like, it was a misinput that really ended Jackal. Technically, Rags didn't take a stop in that game.
I mean, you're not wrong. I mean, even then, like, all he had to do was kind of angle his up, be a little bit, and likely could have recovered.
He could have probably even side-beat right there. He had the jump, and then he started. He probably could have even side-beat and kind of maybe had that trade that he had,
upward
like,
angle.
Kill. But right now, we're going to Smashville, and this could... Are winner semis best 2 or 3? Are they still best 3?
Oh, yeah, they're still best of 3, man. We ain't getting to top 5, at least in the top 64, if even. But with that said, we have an entire day tomorrow dedicated to it. I don't see why not.
I believe top 48 tomorrow.
Man, my man is so yellow. It looks so bad. Like, he just looks like straight up covered in mustard. It's actually disgusting. What am I looking at?
Mustard on that?
Yeah, dude. Oh,
you want a little extra mustard on that, dog?
Jesus, is disgusting. But, I mean, sometimes that's what happens when you get inked up, man. This ain't tattoos.
Nope.
You're stuck with the goo. And it's a very different start for this game for Rags, right? Already in the lead by a good, healthy chunk of percent. And has Jackal sitting in a very precarious scenario, right? One roller comes out and confirm that into a KO. Gets a nice read on a jump with an up smash. That's going to be a KO. Force him off the stage and anti-air him on the way with a side B with maybe an aerial zone. Could be a KO. He has a lot of options he can do to set up for the kill here. But this is where he's been struggling even in game one.
Absolutely. Right now, Rags able to get back. Jackal at 142%. 152 now off stage, coming to ledge at that was actually a set off. Okay, we're covering with the side bait, gets the back air off the forward air.
Because an air fades back.
Look at that.
Dash back forward smash. That's the classic right there. Which every character will help you out. And you can see immediately response to the upper air of his own. But even with that so much percent, I mean, you know, it'd be like that sometimes, but he needs to be careful. And I'm surprised that we didn't see a conversion off of that falling forward air from Jack. Could have easily gotten a buffered forward air again, but still getting the conversions easily off the throws as well. I like that Rags fought his way down, though.
Jackal just dealing out percent right here. 61% real quick, but Rags not laying down. He ain't gonna just lay down without a fight right here. And getting a quick 64 on him, almost tying it up right now. But I need to see more pressure coming in from Rags here. And we're starting to see it a little bit, these up airs. Jackal landing with that neutral air, one of the better neutral airs in this game too. Dash attack coming out, laser.
Rags making the adjustments here, trying to set up the ledge trap. Covers the roll in kind of a little preemptively, right, with the splat bomb. So it was easy for the neutral getup option to be chosen. But didn't quite get the coverage there that he needed. Hopefully here, oh, roller. He hasn't actually connected a roller yet this set, I don't think.
So right now, though, both characters at a high percentage for the second stock. Whoever takes this first stock could gain a good lead going into this third and final stock for each of them.
Ooh, up
and there it is at up tilt. Is Jackal going to be able to keep this at 121? Can he keep this momentum going?
He's on the verge of 2-0-ing his opponent here in Rags. Of course, it's no slouch, one of the better Smash 4 and Ultimate players. I mean, that's why he made it this far into this pool. But again, unable to land the roller, but that's great for Rags right there, because he had him at the corner of the platform, so he gets to wait the entire rapid jab and push him to the side and just get so much percent. But Jesus!
And if you don't know, that paint is going to make it a lot easier to kill Jackal right here. The more paint that you're covered in, the easier it is for Inkling to kill you. But
struggling, man. I mean, just look. Yep. Easy.
Keeping that 165
Jackal,
again.
Man. He just couldn't find the KO conversion. Every time he tried to go for roller, you'd see it be shielded every single time. I mean, just, ugh, destructive display. I really thought that this could have gone to a game three, but it just seemed like Rags was just struggling to find that KO. I mean, right, even from this from game one. Ooh. Catch the landing with the backer, because he gave him the air dodge for free, kind of. He was like, oh, you got scared. I can actually just react to this in back air. Just struggling the entire time to get down.
But guys, once again, Jax Flambeau, House of 3000, we're on for one more set.
One more set.
One more set, boys.
One more set.
We got one more match coming your way before we go into Pool C, which I then have to go run a bracket. It's a busy day, you know. That's what happens when you're staff. That's what happens when you got that logo on your chest. You got a lot of responsibilities coming your way.
I mean, it really do be like that sometimes. I mean, Collision, of course, could not have been run without the helpful volunteers that have been here. I came in with Evil. We helped set up this morning. You were here, right?
It was, hey, I got paid. I ain't no volunteer.
No, whatever. You know, Calvin.
Yes, absolutely.
He came through. We had homies coming through to really make sure that this setup was legit. And then that setups are good, putting on the rule sets early on with pro controllers and everything, man. It really does take a lot from the community to make events like this happen. And this is why it's running well. And man, this venue is so big, it doesn't feel crowded at all. Everyone is here, more or less.
You
want
to know the best thing about today? Devin's birthday.
Oh, yeah, it is.
It is Devin's birthday.
House of 3000.
Chat, can we get some happy birthdays in the chat for HBD. Devin right here? It is indeed his birthday.
The long, luscious.